for his grace. Well, what a mighty God we serve tonight. Praise God. We are so grateful tonight to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Ah, God is good. Praise the Lord. God bless everyone tonight. Amen. We thank God tonight for his strength and his power. We thank God for his grace. We thank God for the peace of God that passeth away all understanding. I want to welcome everyone tonight again to a Friday night, amen, healing and deliverance service. Praise God. I usually say it, God have a miracle with your name on it. And we are grateful tonight, amen, that the Lord has spared our lives to come together today. Amen. To celebrate and lift up the name of Jesus. God bless you tonight. Amen. We thank God for you and you and you. We thank God, amen, for the love of God, the peace of God, and the grace of God that keeps us. I want to let everyone out there know tonight, amen, that whatever your condition might be, whatever your situation might be, whatever you're dealing with, God have a miracle with your name on it. Yes, I said it. God has a miracle with your name on it. And tonight, amen, is a night, amen, that we come together. Amen. When we come together in this kind of setting, praise God, we come together to, amen, anoint you with oil and pray the prayer of faith. Amen. For you, your family. Amen. If you have a loved one in the hospital, you can stand proxy for them. They may be in Jamaica, in London, wherever they are. You can stand proxy tonight. Amen. I still believe God. Nothing too hard for the Lord. Amen. He said, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me? God is good. Dana, God is good. Praise God. We thank God tonight. Amen. For all the pastors everywhere. We want to celebrate Pastor Dorothy Campbell down there in Miami, Florida. Amen. Where the grace of God has kept us. Praise God. And it's the peace of God that passes away all understanding. Amen. That keep, because God has promised to keep our minds in perfect peace, whose minds are stayed in thee. So grace and peace be unto you, Pastor Dorothy Campbell and Elder Campbell down there in Miami, Florida. God bless you tonight. Thank God again for the saints of God everywhere. God bless you, Pastor and General Overseer Monica Elizabeth Paul out of Nassau, Bahamas. Grace and peace be unto you, woman of God. Amen. Also to Pastor Owen Gale down there in Jamaica. We praying for you, man of God. Grace and peace be unto you. Amen. And your family. We know that this is some challenging time for you. Amen, but you're a part of us. We got you covered. We got you covered in prayer. Amen, and we pray that God will strengthen you during this time. Also, amen, we want to pray for Evangelist Beverly Smith. Amen, whose mom went home to be with the Lord. Amen, keep her in prayer. Also, Minister Joy Marshall, whose dad went home to be with the Lord. Amen, yesterday or the day before yesterday. So continue praying, amen. God is still good, amen. Well, Mother Williams, she went home, amen. She had been sick a long time, amen. And I tell you, Mother Williams is a faithful lady in the church. So keep on praying for the families. Tonight, amen, we celebrate God. We thank God for assistant pastor, amen, Joan Williams up there in Limage, Jamaica, and assistant pastor. Amen. Also, Minister Joy Marshall, we greet you in the wonderful name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Pastor Wong, out of Toronto. God bless you tonight. Amen. Grace and peace be unto you. Amen. Minister Cheryl Rowe, all the ministers, the pastors, everywhere. Amen. God bless you. Thank the Lord tonight. Amen. For Bishop Barney Brown, the presiding bishop of the Triumphant Church of Jesus Christ Worldwide, and Lady Gail Brown. God bless you, Pastor, and God bless you, woman of God. Grace and peace be unto you. My wife, Evangelist Beverly Smith, to greet everyone along with, amen, my daughter Priscilla Smith Campbell. Dana is in the house tonight. Grace and peace, Dana Stott College. Glory to God. But thank God she is here with us tonight. Thank you, Dana. God bless you. We thank you. We appreciate you in Jesus' name. Let us pray tonight. Amen. And we thank God for all the saints tonight. We thank God for Missionary Avril Smith, who's on right now. Evangelist Sheila Pettiford out of the Carolina. Amen. Deanna Brainhand, my daughter out of Nassau, Bahamas. Also, Evangelist Bobby Bennett out of London, England. God bless your daughter. Grace and peace be unto you tonight in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Tonight is the night. Whatever your problems might be, whatever your situation might be, whatever you're dealing with, it doesn't matter. We serve a God that cannot change. And I bring a message of hope to you tonight to let you know that God is still a faithful God. And he can be touched with the feelings of our infirmities. Amen. God bless you again. And God bless Pastor Graham down there in Walls of Fire in Florida. I'll be preaching for Pastor Graham tomorrow night in Walls of Fire. Amen. The same Zoom number we use for convention. Same new number we use every Wednesday night. 7:30 tomorrow night. I'll be preaching for Walls of Fire. One night of fall revival. 7:30 tomorrow night. We expect a great time in the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you tonight for your grace. We thank you for bringing us together. We thank you, Lord God, for the spiritual awakening. We thank you, Lord God, because you have blessed us and you have granted to us all things that pertains to life and godliness. Father, tonight we magnify your name. We lift you up. We celebrate you. We pray for the saints of God everywhere. Lord God, cross the nations of the world. Wherever they are tonight, oh God, we pray that you'll minister to them in their home, whether they're in the hospital, in the car, in the business place. God, we thank you because there is no distance in prayer. Turn circumstances and situation around. Comfort those who mourn in Zion. Father, we ask tonight you give us clarity of thoughts and mind to speak your word tonight in the power of the Holy Ghost. And we thank you again in Jesus' name we pray. Let all the saints of God say amen. Well, let's just give the Lord a praise right now. Go ahead and clap your hands right where you are. Let's give Jesus a praise. Come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, come on, clap your hands and give the Lord a praise. Glory to God. Let's just take it a lot higher this praising. What a name. What a name.
Your hidden glory is creation.
Thank you, Jesus.
Now revealed in you are.
Let's worship him tonight. What a wonderful name it is.
What a beautiful name.
What a beautiful name.
The name of Jesus.
Glory to God.
What a wonderful name.
Yes.
God bless you, Lorna Rose, Helena Stewart, Evangelist Carrie Dunn. God bless you. Sophia, God bless you tonight. Glory to God, missionary Barbara Palmer, God bless you. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Absolutely nothing can compare to you, Lord. God bless you. Harry Williams of the Church of Christ. And praise the Lord. God bless you. For Jesus. Glory to God. You are God and God alone. Hallelujah. Oh, Santo Corona, Mamande Lucha. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Yes. What a wonderful name it is tonight. The name of Jesus. Come on, just say Jesus. Right where you are. You don't have to yell, you don't have to scream, just say Jesus. What a beautiful name it is. What a wonderful name. The name of Jesus. All of us here tonight, we are product, amen, as a result of that mighty name of Jesus. And Paul said, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation. Grace and peace again. To every one of the listeners tonight, it's Friday night, so I'm asking you to position yourself. Get your bottle of oil. Get your bottle of oil. Keep it right by your arm's reach and wait for my instruction. Doesn't matter what your situation might be. Doesn't matter what your condition might be. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. The Bible said there's nothing too hard for God. And tonight we have a mandate, we have a charge, we have a charge to keep. And we are going to pray for you tonight, those who are broken, those who are hurting, those who are sorrowful, those who are mourning the loss of a loved one. Tonight you're here tonight to pray for you that God will heal you. We'll bring in a healing to you tonight. Whatever your situation might be, you might have some underlying condition. Everything is not COVID or Delta. Everything is not COVID. There are some people that have underlying conditions. Some have cancer. Some have tumors in their body. Some have high blood pressure, sugar, diabetes. Some are suffering from mental depression and mental, amen, clutter. Their mind has been cluttered. Amen. Some of you have pain all over your body. Oh, my God. So many calls, so many prayer requests. But I want to let you know, amen, that Jesus Christ is still a healer.
We're going to pray tonight. We have the list here that we're going to pray tonight and nail some people down on the altar. We're going to pray tonight. We have to pray for Zach. We have to pray for Iona Clark, Kimberly. We got to pray for Steve and Marlon Oliver. So many prayer requests. We're going to pray for all the women of Zion. Tonight I'm going to pray for all the women of Zion. Amen. And those who have women ministries, pastor. Tonight is the night where I'm praying for ladies tonight. Especially ladies night tonight. Amen. Because some of you have been going through some challenges. I know we all are going through. But I have instruction and I love to follow instruction. Tonight I'm going to pray for all the women of God, women of Zion, the daughters of Zion. And those of you who have problems and has to deal with relationship problems, abuse, and sickness in your body. We are going to pray for you tonight. And I guarantee you God will do something for you tonight. I'm going to ask you to turn your Bibles with me please while I encourage you from the Word of God. Say John chapter 5 verse 1 to verse 9. St. John chapter 5, verse 1 to verse 9. Very familiar passage of scripture. Amen. But I'm going to look at it tonight as God impressed it in my spirit. Yes, I said it. St. John chapter 5, verse 1 to verse 9. And I challenge you tonight to read this, amen, passage of scripture tonight before you retire to your bed. God bless you. Amen. Missionary Edna. Amen. Hannah out there in Nassau, Bahamas. Euphemia Smith. Evangelist, grace and peace be unto you tonight. John chapter 5, verse 1 to verse 9. After this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. John 5, verse 1. Now there is at Jerusalem by the sheep market a pool, which is called the Hebrew tongue Bethesda, having five porches. In these lay great multitude of impotent folks, of blind, of halt, withered, waiting for the moving of the water. For an angel went down at a certain season into the pool and troubled the water. And whosoever then first after the troubling of the water stepped in it was made whole of whatsoever disease he had. And a certain man, notice what he said there, a certain man, that means this man don't have a name. So when he don't put a name on it, amen. The Bible said a certain man was there, which had an infirmity 38 years. And when Jesus saw him lie and knew that he had been now a long time in that case, Jesus said unto him, Wilt thou be made whole? That does not make any sense to the natural man. But Jesus asked the man the question to see where his desire lies. Because some people have infirmities and they have no desire to be healed. They become comfortable in their situation. Jesus said, Wilt thou be made whole? And the Bible said the impotent man answered him, and said, Sir, I have no man, when the water is troubled to put me into the pool. But while I am coming, another steppeth down before me. And Jesus said unto him, Rise, take up thy bed and walk. And immediately, my God, and immediately, the man was made whole and took up his bed and walked. And on the same day was the Sabbath. Familiar passages of scripture. Lord, may you sanctify it in our hearts that we may live thereby in Jesus' name. My subject to you tonight, God sent me to tell you it's time to step into your miracle. It's time to step into your miracle. In other words, get ready for your miracle, because it's time to step in to your miracle. Saints of God, one of the greatest discoveries in the Bible is that miracles don't just happen. Yes, I said. One of the greatest discoveries in the Bible is that miracles don't just happen. You must provoke it. Because miracles does not drop in people's lap. You must release a spiritual force that will drag it down from God. And this force that you have to release is the most powerful force that God has ever given to a man, and that's the force of faith. The reason why faith is so powerful is because faith is God's, or faith is the eternal laws of the eternal. Faith is the law of the eternal. And you often hear me say this, amen, that faith operates and faith does not depend on time. Faith does not respect time. Amen. So miracles do not drop on people's lap. You must release a spiritual force that will drag it down from God. And so then, miracles are not accidental occurrences. Miracles are not accidental occurrences. They are the deliberate act of God in response to the deliberate faith of a man. Wherever God sees faith, amen, faith position you to receive the miracle from God. The Bible said that he that commit to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder to them that diligently seek him. Amen. So God responds to faith. I told you that before, that whenever heaven sees forth faith in the earth, heaven moves in that direction. And because of this, child of God, amen, we serve a God of miracles. I heard somebody say the other day that God don't work miracles anymore. Amen. And that's a lie. Because the fact that you're still standing, the fact that you're still moving, the fact that you're still here, it is an evident sign that God still works miracles. Because you are a living, breathing miracle. Your very life, amen, speak volume, amen, to everyone around you that you are a living, breathing miracle. So we serve a God of miracles, child of God. A miracle is the supernatural event manifesting divine intervention of God in the problems and in the affairs of a man's life. A miracle, amen, is a supernatural intervention by God. Amen. When there seems like, amen, that there's nothing else that earth or time can do, and seems like there is no more solution from men, a miracle is an intervention, a divine intervention from God. Amen. Because I told you that man's extremity is God's opportunity. And what is impossible with man is possible with God. For with God, nothing shall be impossible. Amen. So at some point in your life, amen, you will either, amen, by force, be forced to live in the potential of your faith, or with the consequences of doubt. Can I say that again? At some point in everyone's life, whether you're a believer, yes or no, there's some point in everyone's life where you will either be forced to live in the potential of your faith or with the consequences of doubt. But the Bible tells us, amen, that the just shall live by faith. For we walk by faith and not by sight. Glory to God. So there is a force that God has given unto us. Amen. And that's the force of faith. Faith is a living substance given to us, amen, by the Spirit of God, so much so that the Bible says that faith cometh by hearing, and hearing the Word of God. Then the Bible said, how can they hear without a preacher? And how can a preacher preach except God send him? Because when God sent a man, the Bible said, amen, that the man ought to speak as an oracle of God. You've got to speak the Word of God, and the Word of God creates faith in your heart to receive that which God has in store for us. So I want to tell somebody tonight, don't focus, amen, because God gave us, amen, a powerful statement, amen, which you and I need to get down into our spirit. The statement that God gave us, child of God, is that he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and he is a rewarder to them that diligently seek him. So it doesn't matter your circumstances, how big is your circumstances, it doesn't matter how big is the mountain that stands before you. The Bible said, have faith in God. Amen. Because if you have the faith of a mustard seed, you can speak to this mountain, and this mountain will have to obey your voice, because, amen, faith can move mountain. So I want to tell somebody tonight, don't focus on your setback. Spend your time planning your comeback. Because so many times the enemy have us focusing on our setbacks, and it brings us into a place of captivity. It brings us into a place, amen, of depression and anxiety. But I came this Friday night to tell somebody, we all suffer setbacks in life, but don't focus on our setback. Spend time planning your comeback. Because as sure as I stand here tonight, every setback is for a comeback. And sometimes your setback is for a major breakthrough. Amen. So when it comes to miracle manifestation, we must focus on faith, and we must be specific in what we ask God for. I believe in miracles. Do you believe in the power of God tonight? And if you believe in the power of God, amen, you're ready, amen, for your miracle. Because most people go through life defining their existence, amen, by what they think and what they can do. Glory to God, but and what they are capable of doing. But I come to tell you tonight, child of God, there's some part in your life, and in your life extremities, and your life experiences, amen, there's some place in your life where you've got to trust God with all of your heart. You've got to cast all your cares upon him, because he cares for you. And in our text tonight, this man find himself, glory to God, between the rock and the hard place. I said a man find himself between the rock and the hard place. Just like some of you tonight that hearing my voice, you find yourself between the rock and the hard place. Have you ever seen the dark circumstances around you and been afraid and frustrated and doubting whether God might intervene, yes or no? But I come to tell you tonight, amen, that God will intervene. Yes, because the Bible says that the eyes of the Lord is upon the righteous, and his ears are open to their cry. And many of us tonight, we have experienced the uncertainty of these days, and allow fear to invade our hearts and our minds. But I want to tell you tonight, child of God, fear not, for God has not given given us the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. And many of us have experienced the uncertainty of these days. And because of this, praise God, we allow the enemy to cast doubt and fear in our heart. But what do you do when you are stuck between the rock and the hard place? The Bible said after these was a feast of the Jews and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Jesus is always doing something, always going up. And the Bible said he went up to Jerusalem. And there at Jerusalem by the sheep market was a pool which called in the Hebrew tongue Bethesda. The Bible said it had five portions. And five is the number of grace. So this man was at the brink of grace, but he was suffering, praise God, from an infirmity that seems like he would never get delivered from. You can be right at the gate, right at the brink of your deliverance, and still miss God. The Bible said in these lay a great multitude of impotent folks. Glory to God when he speaks about impotency. It simply means that all the activities of your limbs are there. Nothing lacking and nothing missing. But your mind was weak. Your mind could not, amen, respond. Or your body could not respond to the minds, amen, to your mindset. So therefore, your limbs, something wrong with your limbs. If you're impotent, your hand would be twisted. Your hand would become unusable and non-functional. So the Bible said there was a great multitude of impotent folks. They were just lying there. They were sitting there. Somebody must have brought them there and leave them there. The Bible said some of them were blind. They were hard. They was withered. And they was waiting for the moving of the water. Because the Bible said for an angel went down at a certain season into the pool and troubled the water. And the word of God said, whosoever thirst after the troubling of the water that would step in, they would get healed. Glory to God. You could imagine the amount of people that gather there every day. Maybe they go there early in the morning. Maybe they come sleep over at night because they have a problem. They were impotent folks there. There were blind folks there. There was halt. There was withered, waiting for the moving of the water. Some of them must have waited 1 week, 2 weeks, a month, because the crowd and the press was there. They knew within themselves that when the angel troubled the water, if they could only step in first, they would get their healing. So you could imagine then you might be an old man. You might be an old lady. And you've been sitting at that place maybe for 3 years, 4 years. You may be sitting there for 10 years, how long it might take. While you're sitting there, glory to God, a younger brother have more strength than you. Glory to God, while you're about to step in, he stepped down before you because it seems like it's everybody for themselves. I come to tell somebody tonight, amen, that it doesn't matter who you are, it doesn't matter what your condition. You might not have a natural pool to step in. Glory to God, an angel might not come down, amen, once a year to visit you or to visit the church. Glory to God, but I come to tell you tonight that we have a God who can be touched with the feelings of our infirmity. We have a God that is eyes upon you. We have a God that Isaiah talked about. And Isaiah said, who has believed our report? And to whom the arms of the Lord have been revealed. Isaiah went on to say he was wounded for my transgression. He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. I'm so glad I'm living under a new covenant. where the Bible said that healing is the children's bread. You could imagine this man. He must be disappointed every year. Glory to God. The Bible said a certain man was there. I don't know why the Bible chose that certain man. But the Bible said a certain man was there with having an infirmity for 38 years. For 38 years, this man had a problem. For 38 years, he have a sickness. He have a disease in his body. He need a touch from God for 38 years. Glory to God. I don't know exactly what happened to this man. But the Bible said he had an infirmity for 38 years. I don't know how long he's sitting at this pool. But the Bible said when Jesus saw him lie there, glory to God, he was moved with compassion. God, something must have pulled that man, have pulled Jesus to that man. Something caught his attention. Glory to God, he discerned in his spirit that this man must have tried and tried and tried and tried so many times and fail. Jesus must have discerned in his spirit that this man have the ability to walk. God, but his mind was held him captive. Jesus must have discerned in his spirit that this man was crying out for help and nobody could hear it. Jesus must have discerned in his spirit, and that's why I'm so grateful tonight that we serve a God that can be touched with the feelings of our infirmity. Glory to God. The Bible says when Jesus saw the man, I come to tell you in here, if you want God's attention, all you got to do, because all you need is a need for God to draw close to you, because he's concerned about your emotions. He's concerned about your health. He's concerned about everything that concerned it or pertained to you. The Bible said when Jesus saw him and knew that he was been there for a long time, glory to God, in that case, the Bible said Jesus started to dialogue to the man. Jesus started talking to him and ask him a question. Glory to God, wilt thou be made whole? I believe that Jesus perceived that this man have some faith. And Jesus asked him, wilt thou be made whole? And the impotent man answered and said, sir, I have no man. Glory to God, that simply means, Bishop Brown, he have a desire to be healed. He wants to be healed. Ah, God, he knows that healing belongs to him. But the Bible said Jesus asked him a question. Will thou be made whole? And the impotent man answered, ratchet here. He said, the impotent man. Glory to God in verse 6. Glory to God, verse 7. Verse 5, he said, a certain man was there which had an infirmity for 38 years. And verse 7, the Bible said, his infirmity, he was impotent. He was an impotent man, which means some part of his limbs was not moving. His legs maybe were not moving. He was a cripple. Glory to God. And sometimes you find yourself in a crippling situation. You find yourself in a circumstances and situation has crippled you. But Jesus said, wilt thou be made whole. And the man said, I have no man that when the water is troubled to put me into the pool. But the Bible said the man talked to Jesus and said, Jesus, it's not because I choose to lie here. It's not because of my fault why I'm here. I tried and I tried and I tried. But every time the water was troubled and I'm about to step in that water, somebody else stepped down before me. Glory to God. And Jesus looked at the man and had compassion on him. I don't know who I'm preaching to tonight, but I know that you cried. Some of you been going through some things. You tried everything and everything failure. You fast, you pray, you cry, and it seems like your deliverance will not come. Glory to God. You seem like you'll not get your healing, will never come. Some of you have cancer. You tried everything. You spend all your money to all physicians, and you still have that cancer in your body. You take chemo and you still have it. Glory to God. And the devil tell you you're going to die. But the devil is a liar. He don't have your destiny, and he don't have the time that God assigned for you to live. But I come to tell somebody in here, it's not over till God says it's over. Glory to God. I feel the power of God. I say it's not over till God says it's over, because he has the last say. And that's why David said, some trust in horses and some in chariots, but we will remember the name of the Lord our God. For the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are safe. Can I talk to somebody tonight? You might have an infirmity that the devil tell you you got to live with. You don't have to live with that thing. Healing belongs to you. It's your time to step into your miracle. It's your time to rise up and make a decision in your heart and say, enough is enough. It's my time for my miracle. It's my time for my deliverance. It's my time for my turnaround. I came here to tell somebody tonight, it's your time for your breakthrough. This is your breakthrough moment. You suffer long enough. You're going through that thing long enough. The devil have you locking and boxing long enough where you can't help yourself because of your infirmities and your affliction. But I come to assure you tonight that God said many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord deliver him out of them all. And tonight is your night for deliverance. For we serve a God that is the same yesterday. He's the same today. And he is the same forever. We serve a God that's still performing miracles. Oh, God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power. He went about doing good, healing all those who oppress of the devil. It doesn't matter what you're going through tonight. Healing will find you tonight. For the Spirit of the Lord God is moving in your atmosphere. And it's in the manifest presence of God that healing flow. I came here tonight on a Friday night to tell somebody in here, your situation is not too hard. Your mountain is not too big. Your circumstances is not too great that God cannot bring you out of it. I come to tell you tonight, you're coming out of that thing. Tonight is your night for a miracle. Can I prophesy to you tonight? Tonight is your night for your miracle. If you believe God, clap your hands and prophesy. Say, it's my night. It's mine. Healing belongs to me. You know? Glory to God. Don't stay long. Glory to God. I come to tell somebody in here tonight, I know you're going through that thing a long time, and Jesus sent me to ask you tonight, will thou be made whole? Do you want your miracle? Do you want your deliverance? Yes, I want my miracle. Yes, I want my deliverance. Yes, I want my healing, and I want it now. The now faith is the substance of things so far. It's the evidence of things not seen. I feel something happening today. That devil is not in charge. That devil is a liar. That he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I come to tell somebody tonight, healing belongs to you. It doesn't matter what sickness you have. It doesn't matter what disease you have. God got the power, but you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. And God has spoken once and twice have I heard this. Power belongs to God. Somebody show power. You got the power of God in your right hand, and tonight is your night for a miracle. Jesus said, will thou be made whole? And the man start making excuses, but no more excuses. Stop making excuses for your situation. No more excuses. And Jesus looked at the man and said, rise, pick up your bed and walk. Glory to God. I feel somebody's getting deliverance now. Shake yourself. I said, shake yourself. Shake off the viper. Shake it back in the fire. Shake off the disease. Shake it out by faith. And prophesy over yourself. Speak over your own life. It's my turn. It's my time. For the time to favor Zion. Yeah. The set time has come. Is anybody over there? It's time to step into your miracle. Ah, for weeping. Yes, I said it. I said weeping may endure for a night. But joy is coming in the morning. This is your morning. This is your time for your breakthrough. This is your time for your miracle. God, have a miracle with your name on it. So weeping, I said weeping may endure for a night. But joy, it comes in the morning. He's about to turn your morning into dancing. I know some of you been sick. I know you're mourning a loved one. Oh, God. What I come to tell you tonight, he's healing your brokenness. He's healing your broken heart. He's healing you from cancer and tumor, arthritis, high blood pressure, ear problem, migraine, whatever it is. Rise, pick up your bed and walk. And the Bible said, immediately, immediately, the man was made whole. Immediately, he followed the instructions of God. And the Bible said, he was made whole. It is your time for a miracle. Woo! Jesus, 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 Jesus. I say it is your time for your miracle. It is your time. Tomorrow is promised to no man. But tonight, you can be delivered by the power of God. You can be set free by the power of the Holy Spirit. Tonight is your night for your miracle. It's your time. It's time to step into your miracle. He's present to heal. He's present to deliver. And he's present to set the captive free. He breaks every chain, child of God. Every chain. Jesus break every chain. I'm going to pray for you tonight. Doesn't matter how it look. Remember what I told you. Don't let what your eyes see determine what your heart believe. Don't change your confession based upon new information. God has a miracle with your name on it, and it's time to step into your miracle. Hitoshamanda. Everyone, get your oil bottle right where you are. Get your oil bottle right where you are. We're going to pray tonight. The oil bottle, I usually consecrate it every time we pray because there are new people come on board. And they've been calling me, say, Apostle, I want you to pray and consecrate this oil for me. Friday night, we anoint you with oil and we pray the prayer of faith. Especially those who are sick in their body. We follow the principle of God's word. Can't come to your house, but we anoint you and ask you to anoint yourself. A symbol of the anointing, a symbol of God's grace, God's strength and power that comes upon you to bring healing into your sick body. Tonight. Tonight, some of you might have a problem in your lungs. Anoint yourself with oil when I give you the instruction. You just bought your oil today. I want to consecrate it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father God, take the oil in your right hand. Especially those that just bought the new oil. Take it in your right hand. Let me consecrate it for you. I believe in miracles. I believe God tonight for breakthrough in every believer's life tonight. You can stand proxy for a son, a daughter, a loved one. It does not matter where they are. You can stand proxy for them tonight. You can anoint yourself. And while you anoint yourself, call their names. And watch what God is going to do. Centurion man said, you don't have to come to my house to speak the word only, and my servant shall be made whole. Father, get your oil. Father, in the name of Jesus, I consecrate this oil again. I prayed over it, Lord God, in the name of Jesus Christ, that, oh God, I bless it for the use, oh God, as your people. God, as they anoint themselves and anoint their children and their loved ones and anoint themselves and stand proxy, oh God, for their family members and friends. God, I pray that healing power tonight will flow, that your anointing will destroy yoke and remove burden as they anoint themselves with oil in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now take the bottle cork off, amen, take off the cover and break the seal and take that oil right now and anoint yourself in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Watch me, follow my instruction. While you anoint yourself, say, anoint myself. You said, in the name of Jesus Christ, or in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. He's in the room. He's in the room right where you are, mother. He's in the room right where you are, daughter. He's right there in the room. For God honors his word. Anoint yourself right now. Do it right now. 1, 2, 3. Go ahead. Anoint yourself with oil. Mama Sanda. Go ahead. Go Rabakundo. Yes, while you anoint yourself, say in the name of Jesus Christ. Cover yourself also. Cover yourself from this plague. Cover yourself from this virus. Cover yourself from this virus. Whatever it is, name is. You cover yourself under it in the name of Jesus Christ and speak over yourself. Glory to God. Hear me tonight. Speak over yourself. Should I cover myself in the name of Jesus Christ by the blood of the Lamb and by the anointing of the Holy Spirit? Oh, Ramamama Sanda. Go ahead. Cover yourself. Cover yourself. As you anoint yourself, cover yourself. Your children, your children, your children. Call your children, grandchildren, your mother. If you're there, let somebody anoint you and you anoint somebody. Jesus. Jesus.
In control.
Thank you, daughter. It's in the room. Hear me? It's in the room. I tell you, it's in the room. You know why? Because you are a carrier of the glory of God. You are a carrier of the glory of God. You're saved and you're sanctified and you're filled with the Holy Spirit. And God lives inside of you. Mandabushata.
Whatever.
Yes, Jesus.
In the room.
Jesus, 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 Jesus. Glory to God. Some of you, the devil put sickness and disease on you. Amen. Long-term sickness and short-term sickness. Glory to God. One day you feel good and the next day you feel bad. Passing out, fainting spell. I rebuke that devil in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. It's in the room. Whatever you need is in the room. You serve a God that loves you. You serve a God that is a deliverer. You serve a God that is a healer. I feel God everywhere. I feel God everywhere. You have to feel Him right where you are. And if you don't feel Him, He's still there. Yes, Jesus. Yes, Jesus. Your breakthrough is in the room. The joy is in the room and the joy of the Lord is your strength. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. I'm going to pray for you right now. Very softly then. I'm going to pray for you right now. Right now I'm going to pray for you. Some of you are under demonic attack. Some of you are under demonic attack. Some of you working on jobs and people are, your very presence intimidates them. They're afraid of who you are. And they have the audacity to go to divination spirit and witch doctor to cast spell upon you. So your life can become one of wasteful existence. And you're qualified for promotion and you cannot get it. It's because somebody's messing with your destiny. All that we are going to break tonight in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm going to speak as I'm led tonight. Some of you have been having fainting spell. Keep fainting. Keep fainting. Keep passing out. Keep passing out. The devil is a liar. I'm going to break that thing off your life tonight. And tonight you will be delivered. Because it is time to step into your miracle. Lay your right hand on your forehead. Or lay your right hand on the place of your infirmity. Lay there right now. Lay your hands on yourself on the place of your infirmity. Glory to God in the name of Jesus Christ. Follow my instructions. Lay your right hand on the place of your infirmity. Not on your children. Not on anyone. You lay your hand on that place that you are afflicted in the name of Jesus Christ. And I will give you instructions and tell you when to pray for your family. But right now it's you. Right now this prayer is dealing with you. Right now God is about to give you the miracle. You are the one that's standing in the need of prayer right now, lay your hands on yourself, on your infirmity. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I come against this infirmity in their body. I come against this sickness and disease in their body, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh God, I stand on the mountain of fire with divinity and deity backing me up, and I speak to your infirmity, I speak to your condition, I curse it right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak to that tumor, I speak to that tumor in your body to dissolve in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak to that cancer that's flowing through your body, I curse that cancer, I command it to dry up in the name of Jesus Christ. That weakness in your body, that fainting spell, I rebuke it in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak to your heart, I speak to your liver, I speak to your kidney, I command your bladder to work normal in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak to my great headache, I command it to go in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak to allergy in Jesus' name. I draw the bloodline of protection around you right now. Every sickness, every disease, I curse it right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Loose them, the trespassing on God's property. Lord, let the strength of the anointing, let the power of the blood, let your grace touch them tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. I command you right now, my sister, my brother, woman, rise up in the name of Jesus Christ. Rise up and be healed. Rise up and be delivered in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak to every lady tonight, every sister tonight, every woman tonight that have sickness and infirmity in your body. I command you to rise up. Woman, go up loose. Loose from your infirmity. Loose from your sickness. Loose from your disease. Loose, loose, loose. Right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, loose from your staggering spirit, loose from fainting spirit, in the name of Jesus, loose from the spirit of dizziness, in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, I break it off of you right now. I command you to be delivered by the power of God. In the name of Jesus, woman of God, shake yourself. Woman of God, loose yourself. Woman of God, lay your hands on yourself and rebuke that thing with me. Say, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, this is my night for my miracle. This is my night for my breakthrough. This is my night for my deliverance. This is my night for my healing. In the name of Jesus Christ, prophesy, speak over yourself. In the name of Jesus, this is the last night for the Egyptians you see today. You will see them no more in the name of Jesus Christ. Now clap your hands and say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo! Lord, Abba,
I've got the word. Hey, 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 hey,
hey.
Oh, 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 it's a ring. I just want to forget all about myself and just bow down and
bow down and
worship him. Bow down and worship him.
Something is happening. Something is happening. Fire, fire, fire.
Hallelujah.
Woo!
It's awesome.
Jesus. All right. That was for you sisters that are afflicted in your body. Now, we are going to lay hands on your children. Now we are going to pray for your children. And those who you are standing proxy for. This is a general prayer now for everybody. Whether you're a man, whether you're a boy, whether you're a girl. Woo, shy. Stand proxy for your husband. Stand proxy for your children. Ah, God, you know their name. Call their name before the Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord God, I come against every attack, against every family tonight, every family member, in the name of Jesus Christ. I come against our children, the demonic spirit that attacking our children and our loved ones, that cause sickness in their lives, in the name of Jesus Christ, that cause rebellion in the family, in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind them up right now in Jesus' name. I bind up every false spirit. I bind up every diabolical attack in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord God, we pray tonight that you move on their behalf in Jesus' name. Touch our loved ones that are sick in their body, those who are standing proxy before God, those that need salvation. Save them, Lord. Save, Lord. Save, Lord. Arise, O God, and demonstrate your power in the name of Jesus Christ. Turn the situation around. Break down every barrier in the name of Jesus Christ. And Lord God, we thank you for healing. We thank you for deliverance. We thank you for victory right now in Jesus' name. Somebody clap your hands and give the Lord a praise in Jesus' name. Glory to God. Oh, shabba-ba-ba-sa-ta. Oh, rabba-ba-sa-ta-ta. Very softly, Dana. I'm going to pray a spiritual warfare prayer. I need all the pastors. Woo! I need all the ministers, all the prayer warriors, all those that know how to touch God. I'm going to ask you to join me right now in a spiritual warfare prayer. Glory to God. I said I want you to join me into a spiritual warfare. For the Bible said that though we walk in the flesh, we do not war in the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal, but they are mighty through God to the pulling down of stronghold, casting down every imagination and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ, and having in a readiness to avenge all disobedient when your obedience is full. So I call on all the pastors, I call on all the prayer warriors to join me right now, for we are under attack. The death angel is passing through. Glory to God. Sickness, the spirit of sickness, spirit of infirmity is passing through the land. Glory to God. Let us pray right now. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I thank you for supernatural discernment in the spirit world, equipping us with spiritual insight to discern satanic activities and to avail us with apostolic authority and spiritual weapons to fight in this warfare. Lord God, I thank you tonight to use your word, the sword of the spirit, to use the anointing, oh God, to use the Holy Ghost, and to use the power of your name, the weapon of praise and prayer and the blood and the brutal anointing. And Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I have faithful faith and believe in the blood of Jesus to protect us. Oh God, to neutralize the forces of the enemy. Father, we surrender our lives completely to you tonight. And Father God, in the name of Jesus, we step out in the apostolic anointing. We step out in the authority that you have given unto us, God. That behold, I give you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the powers of the enemy. And Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, oh, we come up against every satanic attack. We come up against every spiritual warfare. Satan, in the name of Jesus Christ, I command you to leave our presence with all your demons. The blood of Jesus is against you. We bring the blood of Jesus between us and against you. And I address myself tonight as a son of the living God. I rebuke and pull down every stronghold. I bind up every unclean spirit. Every spirit that assigned to cause havoc in family, against our children, against our loved ones, in the name of Jesus Christ, I went back into the seventh generation, and I break every plan of the enemy, in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind up the strong man, I bind up every prince demon, every stronghold, the spirit of the Antichrist, every evil spirit, every plague, every virus, in the name of Jesus Christ, the spirit of confusion, the spirit of illusion and delusion, in the name of Jesus Christ, I bind up the spirit of infirmity, spirit of sickness and disease, pain and addiction, afflictions and calamity, dizziness and fainting spell, in the name of Jesus Christ, I bind up the destroyer, the accuser, the deceiver, the corrupter, every spirit of poverty, the spirit of death, spirit of virus, spirit of plague, I bind that spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. I release the anointing that destroy yoke, the anointing that remove the burden, every yoke to be destroyed, in the name of Jesus Christ. I release the breaker's anointing to break down every barrier, to break down every stronghold. Ah, God, in the name of Jesus Christ, every prayer request that it come up before you tonight, God, every request tonight, neutralize the blood of the enemy in the name of Jesus Christ. I break the back of the devil tonight. I break the back of the devil tonight. Somebody help me here. I felt the resistance. Somebody plead the blood. The blood of Jesus. The blood against every demon. The blood against every minions. Every diabolical spirit. The blood of Jesus Christ. Walk in your house and plead the blood. The blood in your house. Where are the anointed fighters? Walk in your house. Lift up your hand. Flash your hand. Say the blood of Jesus. Not in my house. No death coming into my house. I bind up the death angel. I bind up the death spirit. I cast it out. Cast it out of my family. Cast it out of my home. In the name of Jesus Christ. For I shall live and not die, in the name of Jesus. Hey, somebody here, clap your hands. Let God arise on your enemies. Scatter in Jesus' name. Come on, come on. Woo!
Come on.
You have won.
Again.
You have won.
Lift your hands, everybody. And see you.
We're getting ready to go home now. We're getting ready to go, but we gotta put a praise on it tonight. We gotta put a praise on this thing tonight. I believe something has happened tonight. Glory to God. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, people of God. God, deliver your miracles on the wings of praise. We got to put a praise on it before we leave out of this house tonight. Ah, God, your mouth knows that you are delivered. Your hands know that you are delivered. But your feet got to know it. So you got to pick it up and put it down. Glory to God.
You only need to have a 30-second praise. You know your hands know you got the victory. But your feet ought to know you got the victory.
Yeah!
The devil is a liar. You ought to be ready to praise him right now. You ought to be ready to go right now.
I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready.
Yes, 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 yes. Yes, yes, yes.
Woo! That's the war cry. That's the war cry.
You better praise God right now.
Your man.
has got to go. Ah, Rabande Boshata. It's your time for your miracle. God bless you tonight. We got to go. We got to go. Don't you ever let that devil steal what God has given you tonight. You've got your miracle from God. You've got your breakthrough from God. And I want to invite you. Oh yes, tonight, tonight. What time is it? Right now. You go on Zoom and join Minister Evangelist Megan French. Is preaching tonight at Mount Moriah Apostolic Church in Toronto. Lord have mercy. I'm rushing home to sign on to catch her. She's one of our daughter, and she is an eagle. The ID number tonight, 891. 891. 5090. 891. 5090. 8470. 8470. That's 891-5090. 8470. And the password tonight, 117714. That's 117714. Evangelist Megan French, preaching in Mount Moriah Apostolic Church tonight, 8 o'clock. She's there right now. I'm rushing home to join her because I love to support the eagles when they are putting the trumpets to their mouth. Remember tomorrow night, 7:30, Walls of Fire, one night of fall revival. The same Zoom number you use for convocation and the same new Zoom number we use every Wednesday night when we gather in the Eagle's Nest. 480-503-7492. I'll be preaching for them tomorrow night. Whatever you do, don't you ever miss it. Glory to God. God bless you tonight. Grace and peace be unto you. From God the Father and our Lord Jesus Christ, I draw the bloodline of protection around you and your family and your home. And I always say, what good see you when I see you. Grace and peace be unto you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you tonight. We love you in Jesus' name. Thank you, Dana. Hey! My God. Feel like starting all over again. But we gotta go.